Welcome to Kaumudi Global. Russian President Vladimir Putin on Sunday vowed that, as in 1945, victory will be ours, as he congratulated former Soviet nations on the 77th anniversary of Nazi Germany's defeat in World War II. Today, our soldiers, as their ancestors, are fighting side by side to liberate their native land from the Nazi filth with the confidence that, as in 1945, victory will be ours, said Putin, who sent Russian troops into Ukraine in February. Today, it is our common duty to prevent the rebirth of Nazism, which caused so much suffering to the peoples of different countries, said Putin. He added he hoped new generations may be worthy of the memory of their fathers and grandfathers. Putin also made multiple references not just to soldiers but also civilians on the home front who smashed Nazism at the cost of countless sacrifices. Sadly, today, Nazism is rearing its head once more. Charged Putin, who has insisted that Ukraine is in the grip of fascism and a threat to Russian and the Russian-speaking minority in Ukraine's east, which Moscow claims to be liberating. Our sacred duty is to hold back the ideological successors of those who were defeated in World War II, which Moscow dubs the Great Patriotic War, said Putin, as he urged Russians to take revenge. He also said he wished all Ukrainians' inhabitants a peaceful and just future. On Monday, Moscow will officially commemorate victory over Nazi Germany with a giant military parade. Under Putin, Russia has justified its offensive in Ukraine, launched on February 24, as a special operation to demilitarize and denazify its neighbor, a former Soviet republic which declared independence in 1991. Meanwhile, the chief of Russia's space agency Roscosmos, Dmitry Rogozin, said that Russia would destroy NATO countries in the event of a nuclear war in half an hour, so he urged them not to allow such a scenario in the future. In a nuclear war, NATO countries will be destroyed by us in half an hour, but we must not allow it, Rogozin wrote in Telegram, RT reported. According to him, the consequences of the exchange of nuclear strikes will certainly affect the state of the earth. Rogozin also noted that the NATO countries are waging a war against Russia, although not declared. Earlier, Russian President Vladimir Putin warned outside forces against interfering in the Ukrainian conflict, promising a lightning-speed response to such actions with the use of Moscow's most advanced weaponry. If someone decides to intervene in the ongoing events from the outside and create unacceptable strategic threats to us, they should know that our response to those overcoming blows will be swift, lightning fast, Putin said in an address to lawmakers in April end, RT reported. We have all the tools to do this, tools that no one expects us can brag about. But we are not going to brag. We'll use them if such a need arises, the president said, without specifying which tools could be deployed. The Russian authorities have already made all the necessary decisions to prepare for such a response, he added. Russia successfully tested its state-of-the-art RS-28 Sarmat intercontinental ballistic missile. The new nuclear-capable missile can carry several avant-garde hypersonic gliders, which are said to be able to bypass any existing air defenses due to their extreme speed and ability to make constant maneuvers during their flight, RT reported. I'm Neha signing out. If you like the video, please subscribe to our channel and hit the bell icon to get the latest updates.